So good morning everybody, welcome you all in Fluid Mechanics Laboratory, AISSMS College of Engineering, Pune. I am Dr. Prakash B. Nagre. Today we are going to presenting an experiment on velocity distribution in open channel flow. As you learn the part of velocity profile in case of laminar flow, then in case of the transition range in between the laminar flow and the turbulent flow, also you know the velocity profile in case of the turbulent flow. Now practically you need to prepare the velocity profile by using the tilting hydraulic fume device. So our main aim is to prepare the velocity profile for the different types of the flow, and there is a need to find out the types of the flow by using the non-dimensional parameter as a Reynolds number, and this Reynolds number is defined as Vd by nu or rho Vd by nu is the equation utilized for measuring the velocity of the flow in case of this open channel flow. This is an empirical equation you have to utilize for this Reynolds number, but the velocity in case of the open channel flow, there is a need to measure it for shallow channel for small stream. You have to utilize the current meter. Current meter is a device, you know. This is a tropical type of the current meter you have to utilize to measure the velocity of the flow in case of the open channel flow. Now in this today's exercise, you have to insert this current meter into the channel and you need to measure the velocity. How to measure the velocity? So by using this, it has attached with this digital meter, and you know by consideration of this 30 seconds as a time, and you measure the number of revolutions created by the current meter. So the number of revolutions completed within a 30 seconds, that gives the value of the velocity. So there is a need to measure the velocity of the flow. As you know, the velocity is also maximum at the midsection, and velocity is minimum at the extreme end of the channel or at the extreme end of the river. So for getting the maximum velocity, V max value, so it has the rule, those velocity should be measured, and the entire range for getting the measurement maximum velocity at the mid sections in between the 0.5 to the 0.7 times of the Y. Y is the actual depth of the flow occurred inside the channel. So generally you have taken as the velocity V max at the depth of 0.6 times of the Y. The entire depth is also measured from the top level of the water. So you have the section. Now this is a tilting hydraulic flume. Its dimension is a 6 meter length. Width of this flume is a 30 centimeter. Depth of the flume is the 30 centimeter. And you are allowed to flow the water inside the channel. You have to measure the discharge with the help of the orifice meter by using the gauge. But in the today's exercise, you need to measure the velocity by using the device. You know you have to utilize the current meter. It is a propeller type of the current meter. By using this current meter, you need to get the value of the velocity. Now in this section, you have to be observed experimentally where you are getting the maximum velocity, and you try to prove it why the velocity is maximum exactly at the mid section. So you have, this is the section, width of the section. You note down the intervals. This is a 30 centimeter width of the channel. You take the interval of this 5 centimeter, 5 centimeter, 5 centimeter. In this fashion, you have to reach to the extreme end. And you take the interval of the 5 centimeter, 10 centimeter, 5 centimeter, 15 centimeter, 20, 25, and 30 centimeter. At each section across the flow, you need to insert the current meter and note down the observations with the velocities. And you know this current meter is going to be immersed, submerged into the water, and you will be getting the velocity for one discharge. You take the intervals. This is the diameter readings are obtained along the x directions. Also the y depth of the flow, you know, suppose you are getting the depth of the flow, you mark the actual depth of the flow inside the channel. Then you note down these three observations. You take the three depths and note down the readings for 5 cm, 10 and the 15 cm. And for every reading, you are getting the reading for 0 cm. So there are the 5 to 6 observations multiplied by these three. We'll be getting the set of the observations. And by using the set of observations, you have to prepare a graph. And those graphs should be represented as in between this y to the x, y versus x. Y is on the y-axis, that is the depth of the flow, and x is nothing but that is the horizontal distance from the extreme end. And you have to point
locate a point where it will be give the readings of the velocity, then by using the method, that means the method of interpolations, so wherever you are not getting the actual velocity, you have to interpolate it, and you have to draw in a point which will give the same point of the velocity that gives the value of the isovales. So the isovales are to be generated. Also you will be getting the value of the maximum velocity in this today's exercise. You have to obtain it. So let us see, and you have to perform the experiment. Let us start this device. Now in this today's exercise, my supporting team, Mr. Santosh Devte is the lab assistant. Mr. Amol Karni is the lab assistant. And attendant is the Mr. Ram Kumar, those who are supporting to this today's device, today's exercise. That's so let us see and start this device. Inside the channel, adjust the flow on a such way that this current meter is going to be submerged into the water. We have the two devices detected is also in our laboratory, but for getting more precise observations, we have to utilize. This is the current meter. On field, you have to utilize the current meter for getting the actual velocity of the river. Now, in this field exercise, you have to insert in this sinking field, and you will be getting, see, look out this. That is, this cup is rotating. That means the number of revolutions could be measured by using this meter. Number of revolutions. And the revolutions, you have to measure it for 30 seconds time. And you will be getting the value. So the number of revolutions completed by this required time actually 30 seconds, that means the value of the velocity. So as per the location of x, 5 cm, 10 cm, 15, 20, up to the 30 cm, you have to take down the three observations according to the depth, whatever the depth is observed inside the channel, you take the three depths and the same point which will be located for the further distance for the file. Then 10, 15, 20 and up to the 30 cm. You will be getting the observation of the velocity of the fluid. See, that is the position to be started. And you need to check the cross check. Suppose you are measuring the velocity with the help of the current meter. You have to validate those observations with the help of this orifice meter. Orifice meter shall give the readings for the discharge Q by using the expression, that is a simplified formula. You know the Q is equal to 2.64 into 10 to the minus the root of the year. You are getting the readings in terms of this millimeters of this mercury need to be converted into the water multiplied by the 12.6. So the discharge divided by this area, weighted area, will be getting the velocity. And you have to compare the results with the orifice meter as well as with the help of this current meter. So those observations have to be compared, but current meter is the more precise instrument and you will be getting the correct value of the velocity. So on any way, these are the alternative methods which can be adapted, and so you measure the velocity of the flow now. And this is required to measure the velocity of the flow on the river or on river side in case of the open current flow, and you have to apply this entire method.
Number of revolutions can be given on every
okay, by taking these observations with the current meter, this is one observation, then you may go for the second discharge, you take the shape of the observation, at least you require the three discharges and you will be getting the values of the velocity. Then you plot the graph in between the depth of the flow versus the horizontal distance. You will be getting the points, locate the points just like this contour, and you carried out the contouring and note down the velocity. Those velocity is directly getting it with the help of this meter. Meter is also attached to this device, and you will be getting the number of revolutions. So the number of revolutions per meter will be more. And this is the observation 33. revelations are obtained for this today's observations by this 30 seconds, that gives the value of the velocity. So these are the measurements, and same thing you have to carry out the further exercise. So thank you very much. You have to watch this video, and please subscribe this video if you like it. Thank you very much.